While I'm talking, whoever wants to come up and just take a sample copy so you can look at it and get an idea what an audition copy looks like, please come up and just help yourself to one. These are for you. These are take-homes. So everybody can have one. I had them print up a lot. That way you guys can all take a look at one and have one. It's my very humble gift to you guys. So you want to get VO training, and wherever you are in your town, you want to see if there's a VO class or a VO online class. Once you've had a certain amount of training and you feel like you could really start to work, you want to make a demo. And you want to have either a commercial demo, you know, with VO for commercials. And that's probably the best place to start. If you want to do animation and video games, then you need a character demo. And if you want to do narration, then you want to do a narration demo. If you speak a language like Spanish and you'd like to work in Spanish, then you want to make a commercial demo, a narration demo in Spanish. And in order to make a demo, I wouldn't advise to do it at home alone. I would advise to get somebody who's in the VO industry who knows what they're doing to help you produce it, so you can pick the pieces together and also put music behind it so that it will be competitive. I would also advise, once you have those, getting them up on a website. So you have your name, you have your commercial demo, so that you can send them to agencies. Once you have your commercial demo, your animation demo, or whatever you want to start out with, and you have it up on a website or something, just so that you look real and professional and not just like, I recorded some voices, can I send them to you? Will you represent me if you're an agency? Agencies get so many submissions every day that you have to look professional. So then there is a site called voicebank.net. And they have a list of all of the agencies all over the United States. And whatever city you're in, there will be an agency nearby or in another state. And then you want to call them and ask them how they handle submissions and send them your submission. What I would also advise, if you want to get into voiceover, is do as much volunteer work as you possibly can. Call up your local universities, your local colleges, and say, hey, I want to volunteer. Do you guys have an animation program? Do you have a theater program, a film program? I want to volunteer to do voices for them. And find out where there are students who are making animation and show up. And that's the way you learn, is by getting to do it as often as possible. So that's kind of a quick sweep. Does that make sense? I hope that helped, sir. So, here's what I'm gonna invite whoever wants to do, to do. Take a piece of copy. Let me see. I don't know. They're upside down, so I can't really see them, but... how about this? Super Spy. All right. Some of these are new to me, so I've never seen these before. All right, I've never seen this before because this is a new side. I have not auditioned for this. So I am fresh off the boat. And what I'm going to ask you guys to do when you come up is, for each one, there is a paragraph. And I want you to read that out loud. There's two reasons for that. One is that we all get to know what the description of the character is. The other reason is you just get to, like, talk out loud into a mic so your first thing isn't your line and you just get comfortable reading something. So the character's name is Corazon. She is a super spy, a sexy military spy agent stereotype with some strong attitude. Ooh, I like this character. I'm glad I chose it, reading it upside down. She's the type of girl who would spit blood on the ground after being hit and would wipe her mouth with her elbow. Her voice is sensual, attractive, and soft, but when she hits, she gets loud and sounds offensive. Okay, that says to me that, you know, I'm going to have kind of two different ranges, because she's going to be sexy and kind of intimate, but then she has a real tough side. So I'm kind of figuring this out as I'm reading it. She listens to pop music and exhibits her body in very stylized aerobic moves to stop anybody who gets in her way. Okay, that says to me there's going to be some efforts. Because if she's going to do aerobic moves, there's going to be like a... So I'm preparing for that. She's also very determined, borderline obsessed, in taking down the Ultratech, the leading corporation that took over the world. She doesn't care what it would take, money, technology, or weapons. Nothing can distract and stop her from her ultimate target. She is extremely determined. She's approximately 30 years old, American. Voice and personality, determined with some attitude. Knee slide and handstand kick. Reference. Jane Lynch and Wreck-It Ralph's Demi Moore in G.I. Jane. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is take all those to consideration, but I'm going to make it my own. So I'm not going to try and do a voice that isn't mine. So if I can do something near Jane Lynch or Demi Moore, I'll do it. But my voice is higher than Jane Lynch's. So I'm not going to try and talk like this just to get near Jane Lynch's voice because it's not me and it's not my personality. So when you guys get these sides, read them, but then what we want to do is find your version of that character. So if we had five different voiceover actresses up here reading for this character, each one would sound different and have their own personality. So sometimes I do these panels and people try and change their voice and okay, so there's a difference between doing a voice that's like a voice that's a cartoon voice. That's, but like, I'm trying to do a voice that's just not too low for me and I can't function in it. Does that make sense? Okay, so I am going to now do my sample read for you, never having read this before, and see what happens. You guys have an advantage because you've been able to read yours right now before you come up. Ha. All right, here we go. Target spotted. This should be quick. One step closer to flushing out Ultratech. Ichi, Nishan, she, go! Take that! Coming through. Buster! Fire Cat! Out of my way, buddy. That's very disappointing. What a waste of time. That's it. That's all my lines. So sometimes in auditions, they hand you stuff, and you don't have time, and you have to make something up. So now I'm going to let somebody come up here, whoever has the courage and the generosity to be the first player or guinea pig, not really guinea pig player, and do just what I did. Read the paragraph, and we'll talk about it. And I'll let you guys take a first run, and then I'll give you some tips, and you can make it even better. Voila. Who wants to come up first? I'll give you a hint. Whoever comes up in the first couple ones probably gets more of my time. Who wants to come up? Oh, I know you guys want to come up and read. Please. Thank you. How are you? Come on up. You can pick a purple mic or a pink mic. I also want to say hi and give you a hug. This gal has like come to a bunch of my panels and I'm just...
We love you.
I'm so touched by that. So let me hop down here and tell everybody your name.
My name is Jessica.
Where you come from?
I'm from Miami, Florida.
Awesome. So what's the name of your character?
So the name, I actually got two, but the first one is Ryuku Matoi. Matoi?
Perfect.
And what is it? Matoi.
And so just choose the first one for now, and then if people don't want to come up, then I'll let you come up and do a second one.
Cool.
So tell us about Ryuku. What does the paragraph say?
Ryuku Matoi is a delinquent student who transfers to Hanoji.
Anybody the pronunciation?
Hanoji. Okay. Hanoji Academy in search for the twin of the red scissor blade she carries, and the one who used it to murder her father, Ishin Matoi. It is later revealed that she is, in fact, the younger daughter of the Kiryuin? What is it? Kiryuin. Kiriyuin.
So glad you guys are here.
Thank you.
One of the hardest things for me to do personally in Japanese anime is say all the Japanese words. And usually when you're in the studio, they have, somebody's recorded a reference. So we'll actually like look up the reference and play it so that I'll know how to say it. Because a lot of us voiceover actors, since we don't speak Japanese, it's hard for us to say. So I'm glad you guys are here.
Kiriyuin.
Yes.
The daughter of the Kiriyuin family, who supposedly died after a failed experiment with the life fibers done by, I can't even say, thank you, Ragio Kiriyuin. She also shows fierce determination in finding her father's killer. She is seemingly not afraid of anything, though shows a lot of embarrassment when fighting in very revealing outfits.
Awesome. Want to play?
Let's do it.
Let's do the first, you know, there's two chunks here. Let's just do the first chunk for starters.
Okay. Here's the first line.
Yeah, and you know what? Just go through them. Take your time. And you don't have to say, like, second line, third line, or just read them as they go.
Okay.
And take your time and...
Do you want to do the first?
Good question. So, this good, really good question. On these sides, you see there's the black things here. Those are highlighted, and those are her lines. Do you see that there are lines that are not highlighted in black? So, this one here and that one. Can you guys see that? It's the other character's lines. And the reason why they put them in the audition script is to inform us of who the character's talking to, what's going on in the conversation. But in an audition, when we go in to read, there's nobody who reads the other character's lines with us. So what we kind of have to do is read them in our head. So the first one is Mataro, and he says, if you want to get home in one piece, leave your wallet and go. But there's nobody, when I go in to read an audition, there's nobody in the studio to read that line with me. So I kind of have to look at it and imagine that somebody has said that to me and then just respond to it. So that's what I'm going to ask you guys all to do, and I'm really glad you asked that question.
Got it. Come on. What's with the anachronistic street punk routine? I thought this town was strange, but I see the people who live here are nuts too. All right then. It's my policy to see it through when someone picks a fight. Come at me.
Keep going. Do those last two on the page.
That's right. This is half of a giant pair of scissors. I'm looking for the owner of the other half.
That's really good. Please give her a hand. That is really, really good. So, what I loved about it is it was just real. You know, did you feel that? It was like a real person talking. It was like, she wasn't like, it was real. And I love that.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, I just want to make it better. But it was really good. And it's like, have you done this before?
I studied broadcast journalism. But, I mean, it was mostly just like news interpretation and VOs and stuff like that, but not actual acting.
So, yeah, but you're like comfortable talking into a mic and, yeah.
And I like doing public things, so I'm not, I mean, even though I do get nervous, it's not something that impedes me from talking in front of an audience.
Yeah, it's really good. It's just so real, you know?
Thank
and
you.
That's what we're looking for. We're looking for what feels like a real person talking, because we watch these anime to be entertained and moved, and we want to be able to relate to them. You know, say she's not trying to do a voice that's not inappropriate. It's like that could be her voice, that this girl, you know? So what I want to do is I just want to raise the stakes. So let's look at this. Come on, what's with the anachronistic street punk routine? So she's kind of screwing with him, right?
Yeah.
She's daring him. So let's just up that a little bit more. Everything you're doing, I just want to up it a little bit more.
Okay.
And what I want you to do, too, is I want you to take a little bit more of a pause between each one so that you can kind of get your attitude between each one. Do you notice I did that when I read mine? I didn't go right from one to the next,
right.
But I kind of took a little pause to get the next mood. You know, you don't have to pause a long time, but just... I thought this town was strange, but I see the people who live here are nuts too. Ooh, you're cutting them down. So let's just put more attitude into all that. All right, now it's my policy to see it through when somebody picks a fight. So you're saying there, I'm ready to fight you. So that should be, so just again, everything you did, let's just put it up a notch. So let's hear her pick a fight and come at me. Let's have that be even tougher. And in all that, don't lose the realism. We're just putting up the stakes, putting up the urgency.
All right.
Again, because that's why people watch anime, because there's a sense of something's going to happen. Okay, second part. So he says, excited, react. It's a huge scissor. That's right. It's a half of a giant pair of scissors. I'm looking at the owner of the other half. So let's have more attitude there. What do you think you want from him there?
Kind of like a threat, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. Do I give you enough to play with?
Yeah, yeah. I got it.
All right.
Come on. What's with the anachronistic street punk routine? I thought this town was strange, but I see the people here are nuts too.
It's really good. I'm going to ask you one more thing. Pretend like I'm him and talk to me.
Okay. Come on. What's with the anachronistic street punk routine? I thought this town was strange, but I see that the people who live here are nuts too. All right then. It's my policy to see it through when someone picks a fight. Come at me.
Awesome. Keep going.
That's right. This is half of a giant pair of scissors. That's right. This is half of a giant pair of scissors. I'm looking for the owner of the other half.
Good. Now read that without pausing in the middle. Make it a threat.
That's right. This is half of a giant pair of scissors. I'm looking for the owner of the other half.
Did it feel different when you're actually talking to a real person instead of just, it makes a difference,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. I'll have you come back up for another one if nobody else
cool.
wants to.
Cool, cool. Yeah. Thank you.
That's great. That's awesome. Who else wants to come up? Please. What's your name, mister?
Kim.
Hey, Kim.
It's nice to meet you.
Have a purple mic.
Wonderful, thank you.
So, read us the first paragraph and tell us about this. Like, can I see? Oh, cool. Okay.
I kind of just drew this one at random, sorry.
Oh, no, it's good. It's good.
All right, well, my name is Kim. I'll be reading for, and I hope I pronounce this right, is this Digimon?
Digimon.
That's the show, but the guy's name is
Gigimon.
J-I-J-I.
Yeah, Gigimon.
Oh, Gigimon, thank you. Who is an elder from the village of the same village as Shoutmon. He's said to be the oldest being in the digital world and certainly seems to be the crankiest. So he knows, and he knows a lot of stuff, but he doesn't really believe in it. So let's see how this goes. By Devmon's beard, I would know the attack anywhere. That can only mean Shoutmon is back. Lately, there have been lots of serious rumblings in the Green Zone. An evil Digimon wants to be ruler of the Digiworld and has enlisted an army to squash anyone who opposes him. His name is Lord Bagara, and his minions are trying to invade our peaceful valley. I remember reading about this years ago in the village legends. All this time, I thought it was just a myth. According to legend, a huge bamboo root lies beneath our village. Once every few decades, it awakens, pushes through the ground, and does terrible damage. This is known as Day of the Rising Ground. No effect there, I just kind of remembered the line by the end of that.
Woo! Give a guy a hand. That was awesome.
Thank you very much.
That was awesome. Remind me of your name because I suck with names.
Kim.
Kim.
Actually, could you remind me of yours as well?
Karen. I feel so much better, thank you. I was like, you just said it. I always have to ask people their names twice because I'm always like, I just take in the person, and I'm thinking more about the person than the letters in the name. Kim, that have you done this before?
I do a little bit on my own, but
at home?
Uh-huh.
It's fantastic.
Thank you.
It was interesting because you had the page in front of your face, and I was going to ask you to bring it down so we could look at you, but then I didn't because I thought, no, I'm just going to close my eyes and listen to the voice. And often when I listen to a voice, I just close my eyes and listen to it because that's really how we hear voices. We actually never see the voice actor doing the voice. You know, and you want, when you're hearing the voice, to have some kind of illusion that this character exists. So during this panel, if you guys, when somebody's up here, if you want to close your eyes and listen to the voice and see what pictures you have in your head. Let me see this again. Can anybody see vaguely the picture on this? Couldn't that voice he did kind of be this creature? You know, I mean, this creature could have many, many voices, but what he did could absolutely fit in this creature. And it was wonderful because it had that kind of gruff and that otherworldly kind of, not quite a British accent, but this otherworldly kind of formal accent, which was really fun. And, you know, it was like, you said he's very old, and I could feel that he was kind of ageless from the read. So it's really, really good. You want to make it better?
Definitely.
Okay. Right. So keep. So what I want to do is just take, I'm going to grab it for you. Mm-hmm. So I just want to take a little bit more time with it.
All right.
For me as a voiceover actress, when I go to auditions, I tend to be nervous. Even though I've done this for 28 years, I still am often nervous. And I find that when I'm nervous, I speed up a little bit. So, you know, you always want to know, I'm probably going to be nervous. I'm probably going to speed up a little bit. So what I want you to do is just slow down a tiny bit. Because some of this, the end part, I'm going to start with the end. And often directors, like, they direct you badly. Like, they'll start with the end, and they'll direct the end, and then they'll go to the middle, and you kind of have to remember everything. So let's go to the end first, just to be annoying. So it says, remembering and explaining to the others. So what I'd like you to do, Kim, when you read this, is as you're remembering and explaining it to other people, I want you to take the time and as the character, kind of go back in your memory. It's almost like storytelling. Mm-hmm. So the way you did this was wonderful, and I just want to make it a little bit better by slowing down and almost like putting yourself there. Like, you know, when I was a little girl, we used to go to the country fair. So you're kind of remembering it as you're saying it. And then actually, so you're not going to try and say it slower. It's actually taking the time to remember it and share it, like storytelling, that's going to slow it down.
Gotcha.
To his human guests, lately there's been a lot of serious rumbling in the green zone. So this is a warning. So can we make this a little bit more foreboding and more of a warning so that we, everybody in the audience, we kind of feel an impending sense of danger. So your goal as this actor is you want to warn the character that you're talking to because we feel this impending sense of danger. And the audience is going to enjoy that. The top. By Devimon's beard, I would know that attack anywhere. That can only mean Shoutamon is back. Yeah, so that's good news, because it says to himself, happy. So let's say, by Devimon's beard, I would hear that attack anywhere. I'm being very specific with you, because you're good. Well, by Devimon's beard, I would know that attack anywhere. I want you to say that happy, but to yourself. That can only mean Shoutamon is back. I want you to say it to everybody, okay? Do you remember all that stuff?
I remember most of it, at least.
Okay.
Hopefully.
I couldn't even remember your name, so if you remember most of it, you're doing way better than me, Kim.
All right. If that's actually what I've forgotten, can you please introduce yourself again?
I'm Karen.
Nice to meet you again, Karen.
Thank you, Karen. Anybody can ask me my name 10,000 times, because I forget names more than anybody here, I'm sure.
Wonderful.
All right, Kim. Hi. Take your time, settle into it. Don't feel like you have to dive in. Just settle in and do your stuff. You're really good.
All right. Ooh, in that case, do you mind if I just do a few like warm-ups off mic for a second?
Yeah.
Just to kind of...
Of course. If you want to talk in the voice of the character a little bit before you do, whatever you want to do.
That would be perfect. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, so if I was going to try and sound a little bit... There we go. Thank you.
It's great that you did. It's great that you did that. It's just awesome.
By Devimon's beard, I would know that attack anywhere. That can only mean Shoutmon is back.
Good. Do it again and take your time. Contemplate that you would know that shout anywhere. Try and think. I'm slowing you down just because you're thinking by Devimon's beard. Think about it.
By Devimon's beard, I would know that attack anywhere.
Awesome.
That can only mean Shoutmon is back.
Awesome. Keep going.
Lately, there have been lots of serious rumblings in the Green Zone. An evil Digimon wants to be ruler of the Digiworld and has enlisted an army to squash anyone who chooses to oppose him.
Good. Do that again. I'm going to start you from the top. It's really good. I just want to make it even better. Even more foreboding. And everybody, if you can close your eyes, because you'll get a really good sense of this character that he's doing if you close your eyes. It's kind of cool. Even more foreboding.
Lately, there have been lots of serious rumblings in the Green Zone. An evil Digimon wants to be ruler of the Digiworld and has enlisted an army to squash anyone who chooses to oppose him. His name is Lord Bagara, and his minions are trying to invade our peaceful valley.
Ooh, important, this is just a thought.
Yeah.
Is he saying this to a, is he making a speech here? Is this like a speech to a large, like a larger group of humans, or is this like he ran into the humans and he's like sort of like talking to them in his home?
I love that he's asking these questions, because when you get copy and when you get audition, these are the kind of questions you gotta ask yourself. Is he talking to a lot of people, or is he talking to one intimate character? I like that you're talking to one character like you were doing here. Gotcha. I thought it was great. Yeah, okay. It's great that you're thinking this way. Keep going.
I read about this years ago in the book of the village legends.
Let's say there's three people in the room with you. You're sitting around a fire.
Gotcha.
I read about this years ago in the book of the village legends. All this time, I thought it was just a myth. According to legend, a huge bamboo root lies beneath our village. Once every few decades, it awakens, pushes through the ground, and does terrible damage. This is known as the Day of the Rising Ground.
That's fantastic, Kim.
Thanks.
Really, really good. So I have a question. Did you hear that he took all of the adjustments I gave him? And could you hear the difference that made? And those are like all the adjustments I gave him are all the things that you want to think about when you're reading copy. You guys know that...
I'm sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah.
But I was kind of wondering about the setting of this last one. Is he sort of like seeing this happen in advance, or is he like watching this as it's happening?
That's a great question. And sometimes people won't be able to tell you that, so you'll have to make a choice. And you kind of made a choice when you were doing that.
Yeah, I kind of went with, before it was happening, but I kind of figured just with the pace of the dialogue, it almost sounds like he's watching it.
Yeah, exactly. So this is great what Kim's process is, because one thing he did is, you know, he just warmed up, like, and I do that all the time, especially if I have an accent or a character. You know, I'll be like, before I read the copy, like, I've got my copy, and I'm like, okay, hold on 1 minute, let me just find this. Okay, a Russian character. I find the Russian accent. Yes, now I'm here. I'm in accent. Okay, I'm ready to read audition. You can roll now. If you want to get home in one piece, leave your wall. But often it's really nice to take a couple seconds to warm up in the character, which Kim just asked to do. And the difference it made is that when he started reading the first sentence, he was already in the character, and he wasn't finding the character as he was reading the first sentence. And you also hear the amount of, like, acting, like, the difference is, am I talking to a lot of people? Am I talking to just one person? Am I remembering this information, or do I know it and I'm announcing it? These are all really specific things that when you're acting, you have to think about, because it makes all the difference in the world. Kim, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I give you a hug. Thank you so much. Who wants to come up next? Front row. What's your name, mister?
Adam.
Adam, help me remember. Adam. Yeah. So what you got?
I'm gonna do Shoutmon.
Okay. Oh, cool.
Shh, do read the whole
Yeah, part? Read us about, so we, show us the picture. Cool.
Shaomon's the main character in Digimon Fusion. He has one big dream, one awesome dream. That's to be the Digimon King, where there's peace on the whole digital world. But something happened since the last season of Digimon. A lot of evil Digimon are starting to show up. Friends are becoming foes. People are losing friends, family. Friends are becoming slaves, all because of the Bagra army. So when Shoutmon meets Mikey and his friends, because they helped him save him, he got transported to the digital world, and now Mikey helps Shoutmon try to live his dream, stop all the evil, and become who he is.
Great. And what's great about, it's cool that instead of reading the paragraph, you just told us about it, because he's not just reading a description, okay, here's the description, but you can feel he has an inner understanding of the purpose of this character. So all the characters you're going to read for have a purpose, like a raison d'etre. You know, like they want to win the battle, or they want to protect their kin, you know, or they want to, you know, they want to make a fight. But, you know, in every scene, your character has a purpose, but often your overall character will have a purpose in the story. And you can hear he has an understanding of that, and that's obviously, I think, going to feed into what you're going to do.
Right. Thank you. Don't you see? With Mikey as our general, we can send those Bagra army back to Nowordsville. This is incredible. It's like having a whole nother army in our own back pocket. Not that I have any pockets, but you know. You're my general, Mikey, but also my friend, and friends stick together. All right, time to give that creep a real wake-up call. Rowdy Rocket!
Awesome. Give him a hand, everybody. Awesome. Oh, I'm sorry, you got another page.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll interrupt you now, and you can do the second page on the second round.
All right.
Let me just see if this... Does anybody have this one? I want to hold on to it. Myself. Does anybody happen to have this in your hand? I'll give it back to you. Thanks. Adam, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I want to stand. Where can I? I'll stand here. So awesome. Like, you have a total understanding of who this guy is. So now I just want to make it come to life a little bit more. Uh-huh. So the first thing I'm going to address is mic technique. And again, if you don't usually do voiceover, mic technique is something that's like something that's learned that you don't always know. So I want you to hear the difference between me speaking here like this, and now I want you to hear the difference between me speaking here like this, and now I want you to hear the difference between me speaking here like this. Do the same thing.
Here?
Say this here.
Woo!
Good. Now just follow where I put, I'm talking here.
You're talking here.
Now move it closer. I'm talking here.
I'm talking here.
Now your lips are almost touching it. I'm talking here.
I'm talking here.
You feel the difference of that? Isn't that nice? You get this nice, full, rich sound.
Yeah.
So generally, in this kind of atmosphere, when you're handed a mic, you probably want to have the mic as close to your mouth as you can, because I get that nice, intimate feeling. Whereas if I have the mic here, I'm still being mic'd, but you don't quite hear me as well. Whereas this, you know, and so you'll get a much richer sense to your voice.
Much richer.
Yes.
I like that.
Yeah, doesn't it feel good?
Yeah.
It's like, ooh. So this is something you can't know until you start to experiment with it. And this guy is a big, you know, has a nice rich voice. So let's take advantage of bringing up that mic really close and intimate. So that's the first thing. So this first sentence we've got is to a fellow villager. So
right, it's where a Digimon's village is.
Got it. Okay. So what I'm going to do for every single one of these characters, I want you to direct it to me and have me be that character. So when you say this one, I want you to say it to me as that person. Remember when...
Kim.
Jessica. See, I suck. Remember when Jessica got... I remember faces and the feelings of people. And when Jessica got up, did you see... when I said talk to me, how much it changed.
Yeah.
So I want you to do all of these to me and just pretend like I'm that different person. So in the second one, when I'm the other Digimon, address that to me. When I'm Mikey, address it to me. When I'm the bad guy. And you just have to project onto me that different character each time. The other thing I want you to do before you say it, the sentence, is make eye contact with me and then look down and say it. So we really have that connection, because voice acting is all about finding that connection with another character. And that's how we connect with the story and with the audience. So I'm going to start you there, and I might be annoying and interrupt from time to time.
That's fine.
Okay. Thanks so much. Okay, so what's your purpose here in this sentence?
The first sentence is to rally the villagers.
Thank you.
Yeah, the rally the villagers where Digimon lives, with all those Digimons are losing hope because the bug army is just so strong, but this one little Digimon wants to stand and fight.
Okay. So I'm one of the villagers who's losing hope, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't you see? With Mikey as our new general, we can't lose. We can beat the Bagra. We can send them back to Nowheresville.
Good. Tell me again and give me even more hope. It's really... Do you guys hear the difference in that? When you're talking to somebody and you have an intention, it's awesome, Adam. Do the same thing, but look at... Like, I'm this... Yeah. Ow! So, but you really, like, you were playing off me because you saw, like, I was dejected and, like... So I want you to just, I just want you to play it even more. And I'm as a matter of fact, get me to stay in the room because I am so dejected, I'm about to leave. Here we go.
Don't you see? With Mikey as our new general, we can't lose.
Keep looking at me.
We can send those Bogger army back to Nowheresville. We can do this.
Oh my God, did you guys see the difference? Now, I told myself, if Adam isn't convincing, I'm just going to keep walking out of the room. But when he said, don't you see, he stopped me. I had to stay. Whereas I told my mind, I'm just going to keep walking until he convinces me. And you convinced me on the first sentence. Did you feel the difference between that and your first read?
Yes.
Read me another sentence. Who are you talking to on the next one?
The next one, I'm talking to the other Digimons that are there.
Okay. And what's going on?
Right now, they just, like, right now, in this scene, it's... Shoutmon and has finally learned that Mikey has like a digivice or a digiloader that makes him better, where he can combine his strength with others to make up for his shortcomings.
Okay.
And he realized that to be a king, he has to rely on other people.
All right. I am them. Talk to me for reals.
This is incredible. It's like having...
Okay, good. Again, but talk. I want to see eye contact.
Okay.
Because energetic contact. Okay. Really good, Adam. I'm just pushing you closer.
I got you.
Yeah.
This is incredible. We have our own power in our own back pockets, but I don't have any pockets, you know.
Good. Again, after pocket. Now this is comedy, humor. So I'm going to tell you how to play the humor. So I want you to be really excited. This is incredible. We got whatever we got in our own back pocket. I want real excitement. And then I want you to take a pause. And the pause is going to be beat, beat. And then I want you to say the next line, deadpan. Okay, this is one way to play comedy.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? Really excited, the first one.
And then
beat, beat, deadpan.
Okay.
Don't look up at the ceiling. I'm here. Look at me.
Okay. This is incredible.
I know,
we
right?
have our own power in our own back pocket. You know if I had any pockets.
It works, right? Let's pump up the comedy even more. So what you did is, this is incredible, I've got my own in a moment with that pocket. And do you feel your voice dropped at the word pocket? Let's keep the energy up on the word pocket. So I'm not gonna give you a read, but I'm gonna give you an idea. This is incredible, we've got our own thing in our own back pocket. See how I'm going up, this is incredible, we've got our own thing in our own back pocket. So hear how the energy is staying up on pocket?
Right.
And then the deadpan on the next line, by contrast, beat, beat, deadpan, will work even better. You'll see.
Okay. This is incredible. We have our own power in our own back pocket. You know, if I had any pockets.
Okay. Didn't work as well because you didn't take beat, beat. It's literally like music. Beat, beat. And this is what you did. Own back pocket. You know, if I only had. do own back pocket and keep energy on the pocket, not pocket, pocket up, and then go into in your mind, beat, beat, next line, deadpan.
Okay. This is incredible. We have our own power in our own back pocket. You know if I had any pockets.
Didn't that work? Isn't that cool? See, it's all these little things, and you just get better and better at them, and you just get a sense of them, and you watch somebody do it, and you're like, oh my gosh, that works. I'm going to try it. Let's do one more sentence, Adam.
Okay. This one is where Shalman's trying to protect the humans, Mikey, and he's just about to tell him the main sentence of the whole series that they go based off of.
So I'm Mikey.
You're Mikey.
Okay. Make sure to look at me first and not the ceiling.
Gotcha. Okay. You're my general and also my friend. And friends stick together.
That was so good. I felt that. Did you guys feel that he was like, did you guys feel the reality of that? Like, he was telling me that, and as a friend, and like, when you said that to me, my heart like went, oh. And I know, no, but I know as an actress, as an audience, when something happens in my heart, then I feel connected as a human being to the story. And that's what we're doing, you guys. We're storytellers. We're telling stories, and we're connecting other humans to things, to human experiences, to fear, to connection, to best friendness. And that was really good.
Yeah, thank you.
Can I hug you?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Back in the back row with the glasses. Yes. You can go next. Hey.
Hi, how are you?
Good. What's your name?
Emmanuel.
Karen. Come on up.
Oh.
What you got?
I got Tactimon.
Tactimon.
I've never seen the series. I'm guessing it's Tactimon?
Yeah, Tactimon. He's the
bag. Oh.
Yeah, hold up the picture and show it to everybody. I know it's small, but you get an idea of it. He's taking a picture of your picture.
He's like one of the generals.
Oh, yeah, yeah. General. I was just reading about that. He's a high-ranking leader of the Bagura army. Bagura. His only mission is to gather all the code crowns for Lord Bagura. So they rule over the digital world. He's supposed to be a great strategist, but the humans have a way of undermining him.
Cool. Emmanuel, tell me a little bit in your own words who you've decided this person is.
The first thing I saw when he said high-ranking leader, I immediately thought captain or corporal, general, like head of that, I guess, area. And since he may be second in command to whoever the guy he's working for is, like captain.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Is he a good guy, a bad guy?
No, he's a pretty bad guy. I mean, not a bad guy, but he's more of like a strategist, a cold and sharp-minded person that is arrogant, that doesn't think that these humans will break his strategy, that anything he throws at the humans will work, and
yeah.
there's no reason that he'll fail.
Cool. And who's he talking to?
He's talking to three people. He's speaking to one of his minions in the first line. The second one is to a defeated minion, and to a third one is to himself.
Cool, love it.
So.
And let's do what we've been doing because it seems to be working well. So basically, what we're going to be doing through this whole hour is learning on the shoulders of everybody's experience. So why don't you just start out? Let's talk to me and have me be that person.
Okay, so like you're like the object.
I'm whoever you're talking to, and yeah, I'm whoever you're talking to in each sentence. Just project that onto me.
All right. The humans who conquered the Green Zone are currently in your area. They're after the Gold Crown. They must not be allowed to get to it. Do whatever it takes. Okay, the second one. It's rare that I give a failed servant a second chance. I'll make one exception this time. Now go! Live up to your reputation! Insufferable pests. They've thwarted me again. The island zone lost to me, and Neptunimon defeated. These humans are becoming a plague, one that must be completely wiped out.
That's really good. Give Emmanuel a hand.
And I've never seen a series, so I have no idea what's going on.
That's awesome. Awesome. You want to make it better?
Yes, please.
Yeah. First of all, I just want to say your mic technique. Isn't that so? What we learned from Adam is, isn't that cool to have the mic up there and hear your voice like rich and yeah? Isn't it pleasing?
Yeah, it helps.
And you can also feel it gives you that power as the character. Could you feel that as you were reading it?
Yeah. I figured like when he said to himself, it was closer, and when he was speaking to his minions, was a little out because he's speaking down to them.
Yeah, yeah. But it really works well, and doesn't his voice have a nice rich quality? You know. Yeah. So let's just make each one of these even better. So I'm going to go through paragraph by paragraph like I did with Adam. Speaking to one of his minions, the humans who conquered the Green Zone are currently in your area. They're after the Code Crown. They must not be allowed to do whatever it takes. So what I want to do is add some urgency to this.
Okay.
So let's say instead of that, and these are things that I tell myself because it helps, because if I've lost urgency, let's say that this is going to happen in the next 5 minutes. So not like in the next week, but it's like, you know, this is happening. And let's say also that I'm not super smart, the person you're talking to, who will be me, because I'm just one of your minions. So
okay. So
you have to make sure to be clear. You know, so it's not like blah, 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 but it's like I have to be very specific with you because we have 5 minutes for you to get to the specific place now. So I want to feel the urgency, and I want to feel that you are talking to specifically to me and giving that information across. And even before you look at this, that sentence, you might look up at me, the minion, and see what kind of state I'm in. You know, she doesn't have that urgency, so I better give it to her.
Okay.
Second one, to a defeated minion. It's rare that I give a failed servant a second chance. I'll make an exception this time. Now go. Now that has the urgency. So let's say that I'm the same minion. I've screwed up. So you're pissed, but you believe in me because you know I'm good at heart. So really talk to me in that one. Live up to your reputation. Those are words of wisdom there. Last one, insufferable pests. They've thwarted. That's great. I just want more urgency in that. I know I keep saying more urgency, but that's what's going to happen in a lot of animation and video games. They're going to say more urgency. And I want you to think about this as you're saying it. You know, shit, this happened. Oh, shit, and this happened. Oh, shit, and double shit. You know.
Okay.
That was great direction. I hope you got that all on tape. That was brilliant. Made absolutely no sense. It is. It's easier like to not be encumbered. I always end up taking off some clothes in the booth.
All right,
here you go. So wait, now we're finding the mood. Don't jump into a cold. Finding the mood. I'm not a very efficient minion, mm-hmm. You know, and I better not screw this thing up.
The humans who conquered the Green Zone are currently in your area. They're after the Code Crown. They must not be allowed to get to it. Do whatever it takes. It's rare that I give a failed servant a second chance. I'll make an exception this time. Now go, live up to your reputation.
Good, say that as words of wisdom and warning. Now go,
live up to your reputation.
Last one. Oh, shit, shit, and double shit was my brilliant adjustment. Here we go.
Insufferable pests.
No, more. Oh, insufferable, that's a huge word. Ugh.
Insufferable pests.
Yes!
They've thwarted me again.
Yes!
The Island Zone lost to me, and Neptunimon defeated. These humans are becoming a plague, one that must be completely wiped out.
Woo!
Better.
Thank you. Yeah, do you feel the difference?
Yeah.
Do you guys feel the difference with the specificity of intention? Let me see if I can get one more person up here, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, Emmanuel.
All right, no problem. Thank you. You're awesome, brother.
No, you are. No, thanks. All right. What time is it? It's a little past 12 right now? Do you guys mind if we go just a little bit over? Okay, just stop us if it's, I just want to do one more person, if we can. Okay, come on up. What's your name, darling?
Nicole.
I want to hug you already. Hey, Nicole. What you got?
Got Sasha from Duke Painbringer.
Show them the picture.
Kind of looks like tough, I think.
Kind of looks tough like and quirky.
Tough.
She's got a lot of black eyeliner.
Yeah. So cool. It says, tween-age supervillain wants to take over the world, very stylish, has a crush on Duke. And then it says, Eliza Dushku, Mila Kunis, and Will Arnett.
Ooh, cool. Do you want to tell us anything else about your interpretation of this gal?
I just picked her because she wanted to take over the world. And that's what I wanted to do when I was little, so I was like, okay. Okay, so, I kind of felt like I would connect to her character more because I like those supervillains that want to take over the world, but then are like, you know, attitude and everything.
That's great. I just want to say something to Nicole before you go, so it'll give you a chance to settle in and warm up. So, what Nicole just did is not only did she tell us her kind of sense of the character, but she also said, I relate to it because, and every character that I do, personally, I need to find something I can relate to and something I like about that character, because then you can bring a piece of yourself to it. And like, so for example, I'm not completely shy, but there's parts of me that are shy sometimes. So if I see that there's a character that's shy, I'm like, oh, I can relate to this. I've got a shy side of me, and I'll just kind of go to that shy side of me and be that character from that place. And so, you know, you found, and it's so great, whenever you get a piece of copy, you want to go, how can I relate to this? Like, what part of me is like this? And which part of me can I bring out? So that's, like, awesome that you did that. I'm just going to let him take a picture. Thank you, Diego. His name's not Diego. But Diego's a really cool name, isn't it?
Yeah.
I choose Diego as, like, my second name. Thanks, Ralph. Yeah, Nicole, go for it. Take your time and settle into it before you go.
Ha! You can't even fathom what I think by the time you decipher it. Oh, well, yeah, that's pretty much on the spot. But no matter, you won't even be around to see it, because when we drop the anchor, you'll be tied to it. But first, I need to change into something more evil, or fuchsia.
I'm doing that end of the cheerleader thing. That was awesome, Nicole. Isn't that?
Yeah.
Did you feel that she was enjoying it? And like, did you feel the pleasure of listening to the voice simply because she was like enjoying it? Isn't that cool? And I have to remember that because I do this as a profession. Some days I drag myself in the booth and I'm like, I didn't sleep well. I didn't. Oh, now I'm reading my favorite character, so what? I didn't get what I wanted for breakfast, I didn't have time, and there was sucky traffic. And I have to go, no, I have to find the joy in this because that's what's going to translate to the audience. Even if I'm evil or even if I'm sad, I have to find my pleasure in doing that. And you could just feel like just her pleasure in doing that was just like, you know. So now all I want to do is just have you talk to me a little bit more, have you separate the sentences and make it more specific. All right? It's awesome, Nicole. Just talk to me more so it's less out in the air and to somebody. Me, actually.
Ha! You can't even fathom what I think.
Oh, yeah?
By the time...
Tell me again. What? I'm going to talk to you first. Hey, I know exactly what you're thinking. I know everything you're thinking. I know every single thought your little puny brain is thinking.
Ha! You can't even begin to fathom what I think by the time you decipher it. Well, yeah, that's pretty much on the spot. But no matter, you won't even be around to see it. Because when we drop anchor, you'll be tied to it.
Oh my God, that was so good.
But first, I need to change to something more evil or fuchsia.
Nicole, that was so good.
Thank you.
Did you guys hear how she played the comedy? How she did this and then she took a beat and played the, and how she was really talking to me and how there was like real, that was really good.
Thank you.
You had so much fun, didn't you?
Yeah.
I could feel it. It was so good.
Thank you.
My pleasure. I believe we have to stop. I have to wrap up. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you for, especially, thank you for your generosity towards every single person who came up here. Please give yourself an applause. I love the anime community, and I love doing these panels for the anime community because I always find that you guys are so supportive of each other, and it's just so cool. And wasn't it fun how like the level kept getting, you know, and what people were learning were on the shoulders of other people. So I hope that I've given you guys some stuff to play with on your own. If you want another piece of copy to take home and play with and, you know, read or play with friends, please, these are yours. Come up and take them. And have a wonderful Sunday and follow your dreams.